Welcome to Comfort Havoc number 2. Don't worry, I'm still alive. Just trying to adjust these cords so no one like trips and screws up my stuff. Alright. So before it rains, I want you to understand things about martial arts that you need to know. First, weapons are great if you can get to them, but you're not always going to have weapons. So these need to be your weapons. Fist, forearms, elbows, knees, feet. Knowing that you have those makes it easier for you to maneuver in life. Punch, forearm, elbow, knee, kick. You understand? I don't have a punching bag. So boom, boom, boom. And if you're going to change your style, it will go Wing Chun. Boom, 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 boom. All right, now I understand. I had a small debate. It wasn't a big debate. It wasn't really a debate. I asked a question, and the sensei that I follow didn't really not like the answer, but he didn't like the answer. So I'm going to say this, and if it gets back to him, fine. If it doesn't, fine. But I'm going to say this, and you can agree or not agree. Might want to adjust my machine a little bit here. I didn't look like I was on level ground. So as a martial artist, I've been doing this since I was 7, 48 now, so you guys can do the math of how long I've been at this shit. The only difference between me and everyone else is that no one gave me a chance to show the world what I can do, which is why I am that famous. I'm going to jump and spin kick over this without hitting this, hopefully, so I don't break my fucking ankle. But it's not a relevant kick, but the question is this, or what I say is this. Every student of the martial arts, hold on.
Shit didn't look like it was on the stool right.
Every student of the martial arts change the style that they are taught on some level or another. It's called adaptation. Okay, I'm going to jumping spin kick over this now, and hopefully I don't break my fucking neck. Okay?
Maybe I'll angle it this way so y'all can see it a little bit better.
Alright? So I'm going over this. I'm trying not to hit it. It's also leaning, so that makes it possible for me to do that. This is why I'm doing this, is so that you understand your footing and your situation. Ready? Remember, I'm only 5'3 and a half. This is leaning, which is going to make it an easier way for me to go over it without hitting it and out doing seriously body damage to myself. Set. Okay. Now, it doesn't look like I'm getting anywhere near it because I'm not. That's the illusion of movie magic. I am coming in front of it. I'm not actually going over it. It looks like it from the camera, but I'm actually in front of it because look. See the distance? Knowing your distance is what's going to save your ass in a fight. Now, I need to get right here to go. There's a hole right here or something, so I have to be exceptionally careful to go over it. As you can see, I lost my balance, and I got caught, and I would have been on my ass. So adaptation. That there was a demonstration on why some kicks you will not use in a fight if you get into a real fight until you have the advantage of the fight. This is what you're going to use basics. Boom, boom, boom. Okay? Not this. Boom, boom. Because if you miss that kick, if this guy goes, boom, you're going to be in deep shit. Now, if you have to use this kick, remember that you can bring it back. All right? So this guy's going to duck this kick. See there? Versus this. You know, because you miss that, it's going to be kind of hard to bring that shit back. Unless you're Jeff Hardy. So, you know, you can pull off that Jeff Hardy shit. Now, the 180 would be he catches this foot, and this foot comes around. I sent you guys to the places that you need to see that. I will get my phone before this video is over and try to find those videos that I suggested that you go see. But anyway, you're not going to do this in a fight. You're going to do this. Boom, 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 boom. You're going to keep your shit. You don't leave the ground. All right? I know you're all thinking, but Echo, it's Kung Fu. We have to leave the ground. Not really. You don't really have to do a lot of fucking spins. You know, you need to keep that shit basics. Basics, block strike, block strike, block strike. You understand? Block, block, boom, 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 boom. You know, you're going to figure out what works for you and what doesn't. Starting to rain now, so I gotta speed this up. So, if you're doing this, and you're doing Wing Chun from the left versus the right, you gotta get used to it. So, when I'm right, it's like this. Left, it's like this. So it's a block and a strike. It's a block, strike. Or like Kung Fu, it's a block, low kick. Or block, mid kick. Block, high kick. You know, you're gonna figure out what works. But if you notice, base leg stays there. So, boom. Now, this leg barely moves. Boom. Okay? Boom. If I want to do that. Boom, boom. Now, get in, get out. So that's going to have to be your thing. Same thing over here. Boom, 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 boom. This left leg barely moves. Boom, boom. Now, boom, boom. You're going to get that. Now, also, if you're training at home and you're recording, it is very paramount that you forget the cameras there. All right? For the love of God, forget the cameras there. So I'm turning to this side so that I don't look at you and I look at my target. He's throwing a jab. It's a left jab. Smack. I hit his hand. You know, he throws a jab. Smack, smack. You know. I strike his hand, and then I strike his face. Now, I practice this to the letter, which only means there's a 50-50 chance that it's going to work in combat. And the reason why I tell you 50-50 is because you don't know how fast that person's hands are. Alright? He may throw these. And you'll have to do this. So, I know that looked corny as hell, but these are blocks. You know, because if he's coming at you rapidly, you got to block rapidly. Alright? When you go back and watch this, you'll notice I rarely do this while I'm talking. Okay? Because a lot of us didn't record ourselves. We do that shit while we're talking. See how fast it is while I'm looking at you? That's gonna get me fucked up in a fight because I'm looking over here and not paying attention to what this person is doing. And that person will probably switch their game. Boom! He's tackled me. Because I wasn't fucking paying attention. When you are recording, glance every now and again. But keep your eye on your essential target. If this is a heavy bag, your eyes don't go on your recording. Your eyes stay on this heavy bag. So when you're hitting, boom! 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 You know, you can go back and review and fix yourself later. Like, this is wrong. What was wrong? My hand was behind my back. It should have been here. Okay? I readjust. My guards. They need to readjust. I'm going the right foot. See where my right guard is? Going the left foot. See where my left guard is. Now, your guarding position is going to change in battle. Hopefully, they'll teach you that. Okay, it's raining. But before we go, so you have a scale model of me and this monkey stick. Hopefully you guys can see. I'm 5'3". See how tall that stick is? You're not gonna walk around with a monkey stick all day. So, maybe this will help. So you can see this. This is your range. That is your range. That is your range. If you're using the monkey stick on anybody, you'll probably never have to use your hands and your feet unless the person you are facing
is good. Really good. So that means if you're going against Yin Yang Man, you can hang it up. So before we go, we're gonna see if YouTube can do this for me.
Brandon Lee in rapid fire kick in the Fight Club. Damn it. That's not what he was fighting.
Showing results for Brandon Lee in rapid fire kick in the Fight Club, damn it.
That is not what was supposed to happen. Seeing with Brandon Lee from rapid fire in The Gathering.
Showing results for scene where Brandon Lee from rapid fire in The Gathering.
Okay, where the hell is it? That's from The Crow. Okay, this should be the gallery. Okay, it was an art gallery. I hope it's the whole scene.
So this is the scene. Hold on. Pause, goddammit.
Yeah,
so he's gonna do the 180. I'm sure you guys aren't gonna be able to see it. Damn it, somebody's calling me. Okay, spam. Okay, kick's coming. Of course y'all can't see it. Now, this will be your 180, right here. That's a 180. Okay, let's see if I can pause it and go back. As y'all can hear the rain. So he's about to do a 180. I want you guys to see what it looks like, so hopefully it's gonna stay clear. Which it's not. That's the 180. Okay? Let me see if I can stop the damn thing. Okay. Oh, come on, goddamn technology. Ernie Reyes Jr., 360 in Surf Ninjas. This is not how you...
Showing results for Ernie Reyes Jr., 360 in Surf Ninjas.
Ernie Reyes Jr. does a 360-degree kick in Surf Ninjas. Final fight.
Showing results for Ernie Reyes Jr. does a 360-degree kick in Surf Ninjas.
Hopefully this is gonna show the damn kick. It's a really good movie. Leslie Nielsen's in it. Y'all really need to go watch Surf Ninjas. I'm okay! It's really a good movie. I hope this is the scene.
This to be a fair fight.
Come on. I think it actually came before this scene, because he doesn't do it to Leslie Nielsen. He does it to somebody else. Anyway, you still get to enjoy this, because I'm waiting for them to see the scene. Okay. Nah. Yeah, they didn't show the kick. Son of a bitch. Let me see if I can find the goddamn kick. That kind of hurt my feelings that I didn't get the, maybe it's in this scene. But it's actually his daddy's doing the fight. Ernie Reyes Sr. is also in here.
Talking to you. Tweet right there.
Your cousin will have a lot.
No, grab the light. That means you got a problem. And I think it's all because of a deep-seated emotional choice.
Yeah, he's not gonna do it in this scene either. Enjoy it anyway. The mark of Zorro.
Mess with Zorro.
My key.
Wow. Johnny is amazing.
I know. He can get a job as a sushi chef, no problem.
They didn't show the kick that I wanted to show y'all, man. That's the thing about, like, trying to find shit. There is a 365 degree kick. There you go.
Now let's leave for now.
Okay, excellent. Stay out of sight. Let me see. Maybe this highlights ought to do it. Sorry, that was my niece. Should have let me know when my other niece left. Oh. They may show the kick. Tribute to Ernie Reyes. Won the childhood actor success. If it doesn't show it this time, just go Google Surf Ninjas and watch the damn show. News is he's actually taller than me. It's like 5'8", I think. Maybe 5'6", 5'8", somewhere in there. I'm only 5'3".
I don't think they're going to show the kick. That's part of Surf Ninjas. Why is it stopping? That's probably Ninja Turtles 2. I have no idea if you guys can see this because all I see is a reflection. They may show the kick. Section, and that's his damn father. That's him back in the Ninja Turtles again. That's part of Surf Ninjas. There's his father as well as him. And this is him and the Rock and the rundown. Well, we missed that 360 kick. Maybe not. That's part of it right there. But the guy literally catches his foot. If they show it, I hope they show it. That was the best one. We threw the fat guy down the steps. And yes, I am the ultimate Ernie Reyes fan, super fan. But I gotta worry about my own career. So yeah, Ernie, much love, brother. But they're still not showing the damn kick! I don't think they're gonna show the goddamn kick. Yeah, they're not going to show this damn kick. I'm sorry, y'all. I just knew they were going to show y'all this 360. Don't miss this one. It's really a good movie. Y'all really need to go watch it. You will see the kick in there, I promise. Because it's on the island, but it just went through all that shit. But apparently, because I want to show you...
After
I can.
Yeah. I customize everything.
That's how that works. Why can't I change this damn thing back? Really sucks when you're looking for something and you just can't find it. Like, no matter what, you can't find it. Well, anyway, 365 degree kick. He works it all the way around. Like, if you catch my foot here, instead of doing a 180 this way, he comes all the way back this way. And you can best see it in Surf Ninjas. Okay? Because that's where it's done. And apparently, I don't have tissue in my pocket like I thought I had. Be right back. Anyway, 365 degree kick, that's my left foot, and I bring my right foot here, and I spin all the way around and catch you. You will probably never do it in actual combat, but know that it can be done. And like I said, your best references for that is Jeff Hardy and Ernie Reyes Jr. I would tell you to go with Ernie Reyes Jr. first, because I'm going to say his martial arts is unparalleled to a lot of people. Okay, good. My nose is actually clean. Yeah, I had to blow my nose. Snot running. I had to hurry up. Anyway, understand that most martial artists adapt the style that we are taught to work with our body. That was the whole point of the demonstration, and I wanted to show you guys the 360 kick and the 180 from Brandon Lee and Ernie Reyes Jr. before I ended the video. Clearly, I epically failed at trying to show you the kick from Ernie Reyes Jr., so I'm sorry about that. But again, if you go watch Surf Ninjas from beginning to end, I promise you will see that kick unless you find the different cut from what I actually saw in the theater. So again, go watch Surf Ninjas. Ernie Reyes Jr. is really good, though. And I'm not him. I promise. I'm not him. I got mistaken for him a lot when I was younger, but I'm not him. Would be great to be him, but I'm not him. I'm actually a year younger than him. But, matter of fact, let's see how tall he actually is before I let you go. Because I have one more video to do with martial art talking. How tall is Ernie Reyes Jr.?
According to Wikipedia, Ernie Reyes Jr. is an American actor and martial artist known for his acting work in films such as The Last Dragon, Red Sonja, as Donatello's stuntman in Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles 2, The Secret of the Ooze, Surf Ninjas, and The Rundown.
He's 5'5". Went through all that just to read it has him as 5'5". Yeah, so, I mean, it's 5'5". I'm 5'3 and a half. But 5'3 isn't as short as people think. I learned that the hard way. It's not as short as I thought it was either. That being said, Google him. Go watch his shit. This was not in any way supposed to be an Ernie Reyes tribute. It was just to teach you guys the fucking 360 kick. Nobody does it better than him. Just to get that out the way. Nobody does it better than him. Jeff Hardy's really close, but Jeff Hardy's 360 is a hell of a lot different because it's actually a 360 plus somersault thing. I'm sure y'all seen him do it. Anyway, that being said, I'm Echo Fang Grey Wolf. This is Kung Fu Havoc number 2. Be seeing you.